Papa John's. The Irish 18-13 with the win over Rutgers last night. They have a three-man backcourt of Jackson, Kyle McElarney, and Ryan Ayers, who's had an excellent senior season. Zach Hillsland and Luke Herangode, the leading scorer in the conference, up front for the Irish. West Virginia's 21-10, 10-8 in the league. They have veterans and some newcomers as well. The freshman running the point, Bryant, with Alex Ruoff. Up front, Devin Ebanks, a member of the Big East All-Rookie team with Deshaun Butler. Their leading scorer at 17 a game, and Wellington Smith will spend a lot of time guarding Luke Herangode. John Cal, Mike Roberts, and John Gaffney are the officials. John Gaffney will throw it in the air. West Virginia in white, and Wellington Smith won the tip for the Mountaineers.
Sean McDonough, Jay Billis. Mike Gray starts 2-3 zone. He's killing us. Some man-to-man principles out there as well.
Devin Ebanks to Alex Ruoff. Deshaun Butler's pass deflected out of bounds by Kyle McElarney.
Well, Mike expected to change looks, I think, Jay. We'll see a lot of different defenses.
Well, he'll play some man. They'll switch out of it. They don't want to get their guards caught on some of these more athletic Mountaineers that can take them down into the post, but they will definitely play more than just this 2-3 zone.
Yeah, of course, the concern is rebounding, Sean, too. They've got a, Notre Dame's got to do a good job on the glass against in this zone.
Both coaches before the game mentioned that rebounding was the big factor in the regular season meeting. West Virginia beat the Irish 79-68 a month ago in Morgantown. With the shot clock running out, it's the freshman Darryl Truck Bryant out of Brooklyn, New York, one of five West Virginia players who hail from the New York City area. They're excited about playing in front of friends and family.
That's one way of finding McElarney. Go opposite.
You can see they switch off on McElarney. Butler and Ruoff just trading him back and forth.
Zach Hillsland, the senior, missed after the strong drive. The Mountaineers look to run, and the freshman Ebanks couldn't get it up and over the rim, and it's Hillsland pushing the other way.
Well, Ebanks can rub the floor, though, can't he?
Kyle McElarney missed a layup, and the rebound down to Ebanks, averaging 10 points and 7.5 rebounds as a freshman.
How about that contribution? Nice little flash to the high post, and that drags people up.
Ebanks is going to be a great player.
He's another one of those players from the New York City area, from Long Island City, New York. Top recruit of Bob Huggins in his second season as head coach at his alma mater. 25 wins a year ago. The run to the Sweet 16.
Everybody knows who can do what. Ruoff really hugged on the catch.
Last foul is on Hillsland of Notre Dame. There's Ruoff. Rebound by Ebanks on the offensive glass. That's what killed the Irish in the regular season meeting. 17 offensive rebounds for West Virginia.
And it's so hard to get a body on somebody on the back line of that zone simply because West Virginia had overloaded the strong side.
Ryan Ayers, now Luke Herangode. And the Irish told to start. Ebanks had the rebound, and it was slapped out of bounds by Torrey Jackson.
Yeah, when you think of it, Jay, if they don't overload, you should be able to get him. Now, he doesn't get anybody, Herangode. Not that that was his guy, but you've got to come back and at least nudge a guy.
Well, right? And plus, Torrey Jackson's got to come down from the top to get a body into Ebanks. It's so difficult to do simply because Ebanks is not only athletic, he's incredibly long.
Deshaun Butler, the quick catch and shoot. Another offensive rebound for West Virginia. Wellington Smith had it, and then he was tied up. And the ball goes over to the Irish to the chagrin of Coach Huggins.
Now, you didn't play any zone, did you? Very little.
No, we played a little bit when I was playing.
Let me ask you this.
I was so slow, we had to.
But how about the guard zone? Is that something they would have stressed, like get down and rebound? You got to help the bigs.
Well, I think any team, unless they want to get really quick runouts, tries to set all five guys to the defensive glass to make sure that they secure the ball first. But, you know, telling a guard to rebound and having a guard actually do it are two different things.
And, of course, having you tell Dawkins, he wasn't going to listen anyhow.
What'd you say? Torrey Jackson the miss. And Ruoff, their only senior, the rebound. It's a very young team, eight freshmen and sophomores. Wellington Smith, another offensive rebound.
Well, Smith just cleared everybody out using his strength and just out-muscled the Irish.
Yeah, I think that they just try and buy time for Herangode not to get in foul problems.
I'll tell you, West Virginia really pursues the ball out of their area, and they go with both hands every time. Nobody's a one-handed rebounder in a white shirt out there.
McElhone's got to keep busy. Give it. You had mentioned to Mike about screening a little bit. They feel he's doing more of that just to free himself.
Darryl Bryant with 5 of the 7 West Virginia points. The Irish looking for their first bucket. Aaron Godey almost turned it over. And finally, Notre Dame is on the board more than 3.5 minutes in. And Aaron Godey, the league's leading scorer, 23 a game, had a quiet night last night. But I guess Rutgers had only 7 points in their 61-50 win over the Scarlet Knights.
He gave ground there. Pretty good job forcing a tough shot. He just had a searching shot, though, Sean Aaron Godey.
After the Deshaun Butler miss, McElhinney an NBA three, and a rebound down to Ebanks. Mike Bray's concerns being realized here in the first few minutes. His team is getting destroyed on the boards.
And that flash is wide open. Aaron Godey doesn't present himself.
Ryan Ayers to the floor after the Wellington Smith miss. As we've seen today, the advantage for the team that did not play last night, which is very early, and the Irish should be fresh, but they look a little winded as they made their way up the court this time.
We hope a team gets its second win, because whether it's trying to get into the NCAA tournament or win your second game, I mean, you're going to have...
What he needs to do is keep his team in the moment, and hopefully that'll be the trick to keep them in the conversation, as their bubble is probably burst, gentlemen.
Notre Dame had a 7-game losing streak in the middle of the year that really derailed their season. Hillsland a good job of keeping alive the Jackson miss. That was the longest losing streak for the Irish since the 92-93 season.
Ooh.
Hillsland wasn't on the same page with Ayers on the wing.
Interesting with Jackson forcing that last shot. He's got to be able to turn the corner, and I think that can open up some spot-up shooting, particularly for Ayers and McElhinney.
You know, you talk about the difficult season that Notre Dame's had, that 7-game losing streak. A lot of their schedule has come down to who they played and when they played them. You know, it's interesting. Joe Lenardi's 4 number-one seeds as of right now. Notre Dame's played 6 games against those 4 teams. I'm not sure any other team in the country's done that.
And he's got 3 of them from this league in the number-one seed.
And they also play, as you remember, played North Carolina in the championship game in the Maui Invitational. It's amazing the schedule they play.
And played Texas, played Ohio State. During that 7-game losing streak to the Irish, 6 of the opponents were ranked, and the other game was at Cincinnati, which was playing very well at the time. Butler off a nice feed from Ruoff.
How would you like to talk about that losing streak with UCLA at 10 in the morning, too?
Well, that's the problem. Yeah. You've been punched in the mouth so many times, and you go out to Los Angeles, and things don't go well early. It's easy to, for those games to get away from it, but you know, that's the way it goes. There are no excuses.
But right now, it ranks as a very disappointing season for Notre Dame. Heron Godey to miss, and the Irish were preseason number 9 in the polls. They made it up to number 7 early in the year. Before the losses started to pile up, Ruoff for the 3. And Mike Bray wants a timeout with his club down 12-2. Ruoff scoreless Saturday night in Morgantown against Louisville on senior night. On the score sheet already tonight. Sean McDonough, Jay Billis, Bill Raftery, Alan Hopkins. Championship week presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. It's the Big East Championship for Madison Square Garden. West Virginia leads by 10, and Alex Ruoff with this three-pointer. Now the all-time three-point maker in West Virginia history, 254, one more than Kevin Pitsnoggle.
And how about the dime he dropped earlier, 399? More dimes than you've spent in 10 years in New York.
I think Notre Dame's going to have to go back to man-to-man.
And they're really struggling. Open opportunity, Shay.
Well, they didn't bump off quick enough with Torrey Jackson trying to jump out to get on Ruoff. That was just way too slow. And especially, you don't want to let a good shooter that's been struggling a little bit get an open look.
Al McElhinney, another NBA three. Mike Bray's gone to the bench for Luke Zeller, number 40. Tyrone Nash, number 1. Nash has played very well over the last 10 games. Bryant the miss. It came back to him. And a foul as Bryant drove. He was fouled.
May have been McElhinney on that play, but you got to come up with that rebound. That's what we're talking about. If you're in the zone, the guards have to help out. And not a good reaction.
First foul on McElhinney. Jonathan Peoples comes in for the Irish. Junior from Bellwood, Illinois. And Torrey Jackson goes out. Mike Bray tries to find the right combination.
Yeah, they do go man, Jay.
Nice screen to get him free. A little flex cut.
They've been such good offense. Whenever they face man-to-man, West Virginia goes into a five-out cut-and-fill offense, and it does incorporate some flex cuts along the baseline. It's really good stuff.
Sentlin for jump shots down. Nash knocked it out.
Yes, he did. And the officials conferred and got that call right off of Jonathan Peoples' miss. Really the exact opposite start to the regular season meeting. It was the Irish who got out quickly at a 14-6 lead. And then Bob Huggins switched to a 1-3-1 zone that helped to turn the game around. And West Virginia went on to win 79-68 February 18th in Morgantown. Kevin Jones, the freshman, had a double-double off the bench, and he's in now for the Mountaineers with the ball, number five.
Back screen, and they pop out. Well, tough. Yeah, Notre Dame's going to do anything, guys. Aaron Godey's got to get touches underneath and be demanding and assertive. They're just not the same team if he's not ringing the bell.
Yeah, if they're not scoring, that puts way too much pressure on their defense to get stops. And when McElarney and Heron Godey struggle together, there's not a whole lot of other options.
The lob from Brian in for Wellington Smith was a little bit too high. Torrey Jackson, the handoff to Luke Zeller, and the senior missed it. Ebanks got Bryant going the other way.
Well, nice recovery. Leave this guy, though.
Wide open. Ruoff for another three.
And that's why you run. You push it. You may not get a layup. Good composure, poise, and then the knockdown by the senior.
Well, everybody collapsing in the paint. And that leaves Ruoff wide open for a step-in jumper as the trailman.
Ruoff has bounced back very nicely from that horrible senior night. Saturday night, he didn't have a point at six turnovers and four fouls in 22 minutes. And the night he was being honored as the only senior, Torrey Jackson, the Irish needed that. Now down 17-5.
Well, this is going to test them in the next few minutes, I think. They've got to settle down, ring the bell a little bit, get organized, and get their starters back in the flow. A rocky start.
One thing they can't do is become too man-oriented. You still have to have help-side defense to see the ball. There it is, wide open.
How about that? Good recovery, though.
Peoples blocked Ruoff's shot. Jones.
It's like volleyball.
Too many opportunities, though.
Out of bounds, last touch by the Mountaineers.
Number 41, John Flowers is in the game.
Notre Dame ball down by 12. Tyrone Nash guarded by John Flowers, who's just come off Bob Huggins' bench.
Look how active this man-to-man defense is. Out in passing lanes, not really allowing Notre Dame to run any offense or move the ball.
Good ball reversal. And really nothing in the post.
But it's taken him so long to reverse the ball. This has been a dribble offense.
Oh, that hurts. They stepped out of bounds. They're doing the right thing. Penetrate. Aaron Godey finds a hole.
Bill, we spoke with Bob Huggins before the game. He said, watching recent tapes of Notre Dame, it seemed to him that Luke Herengode has not been as assertive offensively, and that looked like a time that that was true. He passed up a wide-open elbow jumper.
Well, you almost wish he'd take the fadeaway or do something, you know, to just be a little more aggressive.
What a scream by Smith.
He is such a tough kid. What a bounce back. I spoke with him a few minutes before the game out here, son, and he was a little down about, you know, what a way to go out. But, you know, you can't forget what he's been able to accomplish either. You know, just don't put that in the back seat. He's had a great career.
Has Notre Dame gotten a finger on a rebound yet? And this has been all West Virginia on the glass.
Nothing there. Good run.
Jackson the steal. Then he missed the layup, and Wellington Smith has the rebound. Rebounds are 19-7 in favor of West Virginia. Deshaun Butler the miss. Heron Godey got shoved out of bounds by John Flowers. And let's check in with Alan Hopkins.
Thanks, Sean. I talked to Coach Huggins about Ruoff's senior night and how poorly he played. And I said, did you say anything to him? He said, yeah, he's a great kid. I called him Sunday morning and said he had gotten a call late at night asking him to make sure that he wasn't somewhere on a bridge somewhere ready to jump. He really did compliment Ruoff on the type of kid he is, evident by the fact that Ruoff won the Big East Means Basketball Scholar Athlete of the Year Award and the Sportsmanship Award as well. I think his character is showing tonight as he's bounced back with some early threes.
You know, Billy Hammer's telling us that 45 minutes after the game, he was still down. It felt terrible, and he texted him during the course of the evening. That's the kind of support you get when you've got a program like this.
He's the hardest worker they have on this team, and he's come so far as a player. He was known just as a shooter when he first got to West Virginia. Now he's a complete player, one of their better defenders. He gets in, he sticks his nose in a crowd and rebounds. Good passer. He's become a complete basketball player under Bob Huggins.
And the numbers bear it out. 19th all-time in scoring, 9th in assists, 6th in steals, as we saw earlier, number 1 in 3-point field goals made. McElhaney drove and Flowers fouled him. McElhaney, a rare miss at the line, is 86%. And then what Allen Hopkins alluded to. Big East Scholar Athlete Award winner, Big East Sportsmanship Award winner. He had a funny line about that. He said, "I wasn't trying to win the Sportsmanship Award, but I'm just a nice guy."
Well, I was out there, you know, like Bill, glad-handing and shaking every hand in the arena.
Maybe you should try and emulate him. You will never be called a nice guy. But incidentally, a great guy.
Way across the line.
But interesting enough, you watched that game the other night. Bobby Huggins wasn't putting his arms around Ruloff in the huddle either.
Yeah, Bob, that night Bob lost his sportsmanship award.
That night?
Ruloff, one of only 5 players around the country picked the academic All-American team this year. He's a 3-8 student, has a history major, very involved in the community. Mr. Bruno's guys is good at everything, just like Jay. Deshaun Butler, a deep three, and it's a 17-point lead for the Mountaineers.
What a great ball movement. I mean, they move the ball and move themselves. Hard cuts. That offense is really pretty to watch, that cut and fill motion.
Now, this kid can really fill up. He's had a great year, Butler. All right, I don't mind that.
Aaron Goldie the miss. Nash, one of the few who can give them a presence on the offensive glass.
Look at the length of these West Virginia defenders.
That's why they can switch readily from 5-1.
There's another switch. And nowhere to go.
Now, West Virginia did lead the Big East this year in scoring defense, gave up only 61 points a game.
You can see the flex cut, the down screen, not a sense of urgency by either Heron Godey or Nash to get out to Butler, who had a wide open shot, but it's really the ball movement and the crisp screening that is getting West Virginia so wide open on the offensive end.
Nice footwork. And look at the counter with the length. Wow. By the way, Sean, you haven't mentioned Ayers much at all. He's not getting touches with the basketball because of that length.
Yeah, he hasn't taken a shot yet. This is Kevin Jones, the freshman, who's really come on down the stretch. He blocked it and it hit Hillsland on the way out.
Kevin Jones working on 6 straight double-doubles. Played his best against Louisville. He had 19 points, 8 rebounds. He's just getting better and better.
Hey, ISO on the foul line, and that's one you got to come up with. Jackson Hustlin right now fighting themselves.
Kevin Jones has gone out. This is Bryant to Ruoff.
Nice slap back.
Deshaun Butler, he also had a quiet night Saturday against Louisville. Went 4 out of 17 from the floor for 10 points. The volleyball game continues on the offensive glass. And Ebanks was fouled on the floor.
Yeah, one of those that came down off Jackson from the top, Sean, but you can't continue to get back in the game if you don't rebound. And it's just not as good an effort. You got to whack somebody.
9 offensive rebounds for West Virginia in under 12 minutes. Deshaun Butler the miss, Heron Godey the rebound.
Boy, it's really the lack of scoring for Notre Dame. Who would have thought that, you know, after 12 minutes or 13 minutes of play, they'd only have 6 points? I mean, that's amazing.
They've been struggling of late to ring the bell.
Wellington Smith fouled Heron Godey in a timeout. When we come back, a championship week update. And, of course, DePaul made it a bigger story when they upset Cincinnati for their only conference win this year. But here we are now halfway through day 2, and those 4 teams that wouldn't have been here last year are all gone already.
You know, the argument that for DePaul, it worked out. You know, all the teams should come or not. And, you know, the amazing thing with DePaul, it's so good for those kids to get a win. You know, you think of the Lions with their loss, you know, lost every game this year in football. Those guys are free agents. They're going on. But this program, very meaningful. So I mean, there's both sides of that argument.
But, you know, you also have to balance that against what it does to Providence. You know, you also want to protect your better teams. And Providence didn't get anything with the committee by beating DePaul.
No.
And now they go up against Louisville, and they may be a more tired team as a result of it. Who knows? But, you know, your point well taken about DePaul and, you know, getting their win. And how great that is for each player to be able to play in the tournament. But maybe it's to the detriment of the better teams in the league.
They need these badly.
That could help Haragoti, believe it or not. One of the few clean looks they've had, and Ayers playing very well coming down the stretch.
It's his first shot. Yeah. He's taken one shot now. Haragoti's attempted four shots. McElhinney's 0 for 4. The big guns have not been firing for the Irish.
Look at this. Over his own guy. Oh, that could be illegal climbing.
Wellington Smith went over Deshaun Butler but missed the tip. Here's Torrey Jackson with an open look. Hills laying the tip. Ebanks.
Nice defense. Oh, they got the charge. I don't know.
And Mike Bray needs to be careful. Mike Roberts just gave him a look, but I don't blame Mike Bray from this vantage point. That looked like a charge.
Yeah, I would agree. But this is incredible. That's how Jay got up to dunk the ball, I think, in his day.
Oh, that was me undercutting my teammate.
That was Allery under there. Oh, that is terrific. Some springs.
Colin McElhinney, his second. So here's Ebanks, freshman from Long Island City. Originally was headed to Indiana, but then after the mess there, Kelvin Sampson departing, he elected to come to West Virginia.
Oh, he was even.
That's a charge.
Yeah, no question. I don't blame Mike at all. You know what I thought was interesting, Sean and Jay, when Bobby was talking about Devin Ebanks, you tell him one thing once and he's got it. And that's the sign of a kid with focus and a big upside. He's going to.
What?
That took him back to his coaching days.
Yes. We said that's really true of Kevin Jones as well. He has, as Bob put it, a couple of freshmen who have a great aptitude for learning, and they've all improved under his tutelage.
Now, we've been trying to bring you along.
I have no chance.
I wouldn't call it tutelage.
Beyond hope.
And a little nickel dimer.
Anytime you put two hands on a ball handler, that's an absolute that will get called, even though it looked incidental.
First foul on Ruoff, fourth on the team. Kevin Jones comes back in. And Ebanks goes out.
And Bobby very tough on himself. Huh? Nice little down screen to get McElhinney a look.
Boy, and he has his first bucket of the night. Another guy playing in his neighborhood from Staten Island, New York.
Catholic out in the island. Phenomenal range as a high school kid. Continued it at Notre Dame.
Notre Dame sticking with his 2-3 zone after a make.
Nice pass. Oh, my goodness. Wide open. Should have gone to the rim, really.
And Jones missed it. Here's McElhinney, the Irish, trying to scratch back into the game. Down by 16, under 5.5 to go in the half.
There is nowhere to go. Chuck Bryant did a great job of staying in front of Torrey Jackson.
And that let Ruoff stay on McElhinney, therefore the steal.
And Ruoff missed a fadeaway, tipped it away from Ayers, but gets called for the foul. It might not have been on Ruoff. John Cal was pointing at Wellington Smith away from the ball. And it is on Smith, his second. The league's leading scorer with only 2 points after he was held to 7 last night. Mike Bray said he was bothered by the height inside of Rutgers.
Mm-hmm. Anytime you've got big guys like Khabib, it makes it difficult for him. I think he's got to attack the body, but he can't get in position because of the great denial.
Well, they can't get him the ball.
Yeah.
And nobody can see anything. There's no passes that they're at. Look how far they have to go out to catch it. You can't run your offense from 40 feet from the basket.
Boy, this is Bearcat defense when he was at Cincinnati, Bobby.
McElhinney.
They won't leave him.
This is a pounded into the deck. They've got absolutely nothing.
You got a timeout with 5 on the clock. Great defense. What a sequence.
The Irish have been struggling to score of late. They haven't scored over 70 in any of their last 5 games. West Virginia leading Notre Dame 27-11. Just over 4.5 minutes left in the first half. Second round action of the Big East Championship.
Boy, this man-to-man defense by West Virginia has been excellent. They are switching just about every exchange. They are alert on the help side, even though they're not over-helping. And they're denying entries. They're denying passes. They're making it more difficult to run any kind of offense. And they haven't gotten a clean look all game long.
Look at that. We're going to hit the glass. Violation. And they back that up with great defense. Bryant containing. Ruoff getting the steal and the run out.
There hasn't been one clean look at the basket for Notre Dame in this entire ballgame.
A team that scores over 77 points per game, as we noted right before the break. Scuffling offensively lately. They are the best three-point shooting team in the league. They might need that weapon if they're going to get back into this one tonight.
Well, they are just getting whatever they want right here. Little kiss. It was set up by the party defense as Ebanks finishes it.
Ebanks has really turned into a playmaker in the middle of that zone, just flashing into the middle, catching and facing and making a play.
He has 5 points tonight. Aaron Godey bouncing with Jones.
Jones really did a nice job on him, even though he faked that charge. He was active.
And there's Deshaun Butler. And Mike Bray is whipping through his timeouts. 7 points for Deshaun Butler, who averages 17 points per game. He was second team All Big East this season.
Hey, Jay, you've got a lot of pressure on you when you can't stop people. There's every trip, open opportunities, and you are being defended at the other end and not coming up with many clean ones.
Well, and Heron Godey's got to be more active. I mean, they just dump it down to that short corner after Ayers had to help up, and Heron Godey's got to be the guy that gets out there.
Let's take a look now at some Big East headlines. We mentioned the early story. The first game of this championship came yesterday when DePaul beat Cincinnati, the Blue Demons' only conference win. They lost today to Providence, even though DePaul led through most of that game. St. John's beat Georgetown yesterday. They got hammered by Marquette today, scored a championship low 10 points in the first half. And the Louisville Cardinals with a double bye, but Terrence Williams and his mates in the building right now watching this game. They'll get underway tomorrow. Kyle McElarney, 4-3.
That's one of the few mistakes defensively that they have made. And by the way, Williams had some year, didn't he, running the show for Louisville?
I was just going to say, I think he should have been, if there were going to be co-players of the year, he should have been one of them.
Right.
And he had a great year. His team won the league. I don't think anybody was more consistent at a high level in doing so many different things as Terrence Williams.
Shooting gallery.
Darryl Bryant has 13 points. He averages 9.5 per game. We mentioned at the start, he's a freshman back in his hometown, New York City. He said, I like playing in front of friends and family. I look forward to it. And Bob Huggins said, he's a very confident young man.
Big stage, well, New Yorkers.
He had to take on a lot ever since West Virginia lost Joe Mazzulla in this building against Davidson.
That's what he does well. Spaced up the foul line because in the corner, McElarney was trapped.
There's the second bucket for Heron Godey, who has led the league in scoring now in back-to-back years.
Back to man-to-man for Notre Dame.
Heron Godey's the only player in the history of the Big East to lead the conference in scoring 2 years in a row. Butler, and the rebound down to Tyrone Nash.
Notre Dame's playing such a soft man. They're really not putting any pressure on the perimeter on West Virginia.
Mike Gray wants to push it to get opportunities quickly and early, and they have not been able to do it.
Timeout, 2:03. Remaining in the first half as West Virginia tries to make history in the Big East. Tomorrow afternoon with Dan Shulman and Len Elmore on the call. Ebanks with another rebound, and the rebounding edge continues. That's his seventh in the West Virginia Mountaineers, uncharacteristically accurate from beyond the arc tonight with 7 threes already.
And when they cut quickly. Ebanks, a guy that makes plays, over 2 assists a game as well.
Those back cuts really flatten out this defense and allow the shooters to step into their shots on the perimeter.
He's got a live body, too.
Shot clock running out. So Butler takes a long two, and Heron Godey the rebound. Cam Thurman has come in for West Virginia, number two. Peoples goes into Thurman, who deflected it out of bounds.
Yeah, pretty good aggressive play. They just looking for some spark in the...
Thurman's the type that can play Heron Godey physically.
Oh, boy. What a great cut, too.
And Peoples missed an easy shot.
stop and score, you got to think of your ND.
Under a minute to go now in the first half.
How about that? A little step back. Kiss smooch on MSG.
9 for Deshaun Butler. He had 19 in their regular season win against the Irish. Ayers, the backer, off a good setup from McElarney.
A little life, maybe, huh? One more stop. Give you an opportunity to go in with a little confidence.
Timeout, West Virginia. 32.4 to go and 28 on the shot clock. Here in the first half, the three-point ball, a big weapon for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, as you mentioned, Jay, just enough pressure to give them confidence almost.
Well, Notre Dame's going out there to hope they miss. They've got to go out to make a miss, and that's not been happening. I mean, you know, Truck Bryant doesn't get that much time to shoot in a horse game, let alone in a Big East tournament game. So, you know, Notre Dame has to do a better job on the defensive end. But West Virginia's defense has been spectacular, just spectacular.
And Andy tardy on their closeouts and challenges. How about that, huh? Make you smile, Sean.
Yeah, 11th in the Big East during the season at 33%, but 50% tonight. Against the Notre Dame team, to me, guys, it looks like they're out of gas. And I know they're not particularly deep. There are an awful lot of times we've watched them play this year where early in games you see a lot of huffing and puffing. It almost makes you wonder about their conditioning.
Well, a lot of minutes against some great great schedule. I think losing those, what, 7 in a row is something that suffocates you somewhere along the line. It takes a little.
They're beaten down. They're just beaten down. But this schedule has beaten them up, and they look it. They look like they've gone 14 rounds with the champ, and they're staggering out for the 15th.
They don't go 12 anymore, by the way. They've changed the rules.
Well, they look like they're going longer than that.
They're going to overtime. Hillsland had a rebound. It was slapped away, and it was last touched by Notre Dame. And Mike Bray says this half cannot get over quickly enough.
How about they're going ultimate fighting against Chuck Liddell?
That ain't showing your youth, or at least your son's interest.
Butler amiss. And it's halftime. West Virginia has doubled up Notre Dame. Bob Huggins and the Mountaineers leading 36-18 at the break. Bryant had 13 points to lead West Virginia. Now let's send you back to Reese Davis in the studio. Here's the Cisco halftime report.